name is Paul Conroy. I'm an American citizen from Hastings, Michigan. I'm a civilian truck driver for Creston, Roland, and Thomas. And I've been taken hostage somewhere in Iraq.
Vamos a demostrar cómo efectivamente un actor tirando a tocho puede girarse completamente dentro de un ataúd, poniendo sus pies donde tenía la cara y la cara donde tenía los pies. En este caso será nuestro operador, Eduardo Brown. Cuando quieras. Hacer una peli ahí dentro.
This is a kind of movie that should be done. It's nonsense. It's foolish. Doing a film inside a coffin for 90 minutes. Are you kidding?
You know, it's just a leap of faith.
So I just kept scaling and scaling and scaling until I literally had one actor in one location.
Realmente puede ser la mayor marcianada del mundo o una genialidad.
Somebody pitched me the idea we're going to do a movie of a guy in a box. I would say they were insane.
Estamos enterrando a un tipo en un ataúd.
Estamos hablando de una peli con dos cámaras rodando 35 planos diarios.
Buf, hacer una película en un ataúd parece una odisea, ¿no? Todo en un ataúd y te dicen, hostia, ¿y qué vas a hacer? ¿Qué? Todo el rato en el mismo plano, en la misma luz.
Stories are big, not coffins are big or locations are big.
If Alfred Hitchcock had been given the script 50 years ago, he would have made this movie.
And you make a feature-length movie that doesn't leave such a confined space.
If I were in that situation, how would I react?
The first minute, you will have to take a deep breath because that's the only thing you are going to do. That's what Burry did.
Hi, guys. Remember this. There are about 40,000 reasons for not making this movie. And there's only one for making it. But that's the one that counts. It made me happy and made my producers rich, like the tiger. Thanks.
We had just 17 days. We had to do the whole movie, the whole 94-minute movie, in just 17 days. For Ryan's schedule, and because of Ryan's mental and physical health, too.
And action.
It sounds like it would be sort of on paper, it sounds like it would be easy, you know, shoot a movie in a coffin. How hard is that? But you know, there's rarely a time in this film where we even repeat a shot. You know, and if you think about 88 minutes or so, you know, in one location with one person, that's a feat. I mean, that's a feat of engineering.
Silencio, por favor.
That's rough. Okay. We'll use it.
We're chronological.
Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah.
You ended with the light off, so everything will start in darkness with flashing blue light. So you wake up surprised and you hit your head.
Yeah.
Ah!
I still wonder why Ryan accepted. I guess it was because of my poor English. There's something that he didn't understand, and he understood it when it was too late, thank God, when he was there. Sent him back to LA with his back bleeding and his fingers literally fried because of the lighter, because of the Zippo, and with his skin totally destroyed.
It's tough to say that there's a good part of working in a coffin. I'm not sure there is. It's a pretty tough job, but someone's got to do it.
Ryan is like a Stradivarius because he can do whatever.
Siempre muy concentrado, siempre siendo Paul Conroy toda la película, todos los días de rodaje.
Él es un trabajador nato increíble y creo que es un tío muy potente.
Cuando le dábamos una linterna que si no la hacía él funcionar, no había una manera posible de que funcionase para la secuencia. Él lo hacía de una manera que hacía que pareciera fácil una cosa que no es fácil.
Cómo mira, cómo reacciona, cómo escucha, cómo coge algo, cómo mira alrededor. Cuando eso sucede y la magia está en acción, es la verdad pasando. Y eso es lo que sucede con Ryan Reynolds.
He is a movie star, but he has that kind of quality of he's just a guy. He's just a guy just like any other person, you know, and for a girl it's he's just a person. He just I could be in that predicament. It's possible.
He never acts. He always is. You cannot catch him lying. He never lies.